Welcome back to Henry TV. I am your host, 22 Plinkster. Look what I got in my hand. Bam! The new Henry axe gun, chambered in 410. Let's get into the video. The axe gun is part of Henry's brand new lineup. Now, this is a 410 side loading gate firearm. By the ATF's definition, this is not a pistol, this is not a rifle, and this is not even a shotgun. This is labeled by the ATF as a firearm. The forearm of the axe gun is made from walnut, and the rear, the grip right back here, is also made from walnut. You may notice it's kind of shaped like an axe handle. That's how Henry came up with the name, the axe gun. It holds 5 in the magazine tube of 2.5-inch 410 shot shells. It is drilled and tapped on top of the receiver so you can mount an optic of your choice. And it also has sling mounts on the rear and also on the forearm. One of the cool things about the axe gun is right here. Now, I'm not talking about the brass front bead. I am talking about the Invector style choke tubes. You can replace the choke tubes with a modified improved cylinder or even an extra full turkey choke and put it inside of the axe gun, which is pretty cool. I plan on taking this guy turkey hunting this year in Tennessee. The barrel is a little bit over 15 inches, and the firearm weighs just a little under 6 pounds. It's pretty hefty, but that helps tame the recoil of the 410. Now that we went over some of the features of the axe gun, let's do some shooting. All right, I have loaded up some 8.5 shot shotgun shells in the axe gun. Now I've got a few skeet here. I'm gonna try to toss them up and hit them. I don't know how well I'm gonna do with this. Not bad. Let's try it again. Oh, I probably got one pellet in it. I didn't hit that thing good at all. I missed that one clean. I hit the first one good. There we go. All right, una mas. Oh, I barely nicked it. It's fun to shoot. It takes a little while to get used to, but it's definitely fun to shoot. One of the cool things about the 410 is its versatility. I was shooting some 8.5 shot while he goes at clay. That's perfect for like any kind of bird hunting or anything in the air. Now I've switched over to some rifled slugs. I'm gonna try to attempt to hit silhouette plates downrange at about 50 yards with just a bead sight and trying to hold the axe gun just right. I think my point of aim is gonna be a little low. I think I have to aim at about 6 o'clock from this distance. I've tried it a few times off camera, so I'm not making any promises. I'm just making excuses if I miss. All right, here we go. Did I hit it? Nope. Or did I? I don't see it moving. No, right to the left. I saw that one. Oh, I hit it that time. That's 50 yards. Do I get froggy and try to hit it at 100? Let's just try. 100 yards. Oh, right to the left of it. All right, let me aim a little bit higher and to the right. Oh, I nailed it. 100 yards with a rifled slug. All right, now I'm gonna load up some triple-aught buck. This has 3 BBs in it and it's moving pretty good. This is designed for home defense, so if you want to consider the axe gun for home defense, there is an option for ammunition that is available. So I'm just going to put some here on steel pretty close. And let's start off with this silhouette right here. Wow. Click. That would definitely get the job done. The beautiful thing about firearms is not that everyone that you purchase has to be practical. I own a lot of firearms that aren't extremely practical. This firearm, the axe gun, kind of falls into that category. It's not really made to go hunting or shoot skeet competition with. It's not designed to do that. This is one of these firearms that are just fun to shoot. Now, can you hunt with it? Yes. Can you take it to the skeet range? Yes, you can. And you can have a lot of fun doing it. But this gun, in my opinion, it just falls into the category of just one of those really, really fun guns to shoot. Guys, thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any questions for Henry, you can put them in the comments below. You can go over to the Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter pages and ask them there. And remember, if it's not made in America, it's not going to be made at all.